What is going on, guys, and welcome your face back to another video. Today I have 18 new gameplay facts that make Just Cause 4 better than Just Cause 3. Technically it's 19, but the 19 is more or less including the new vehicle that is in this game as well. So if you guys are excited for this game, drop a like on this video. If you cannot contain your hype, I still want to see so much more gameplay. We still have like 3 more biomes to see of just raw gameplay, so hopefully we get that over the next couple of days, or at least maybe the end of the month, maybe early next month, who the heck knows. But let me know which biome you also want to see next in the comment section below. Now diving straight into the first thing I really want to share with you guys, just in case you didn't know, I didn't spot this, but on the deluxe digital edition, or gold edition I think it's in as well, there is a special vehicle. Now it's called the Black Hand Stealth Microjet. Now basically it's a special aircraft that has retractable wings and an experimental stealth optic camouflage on top of an elite onboard attack arsenal. So it says fight back against the Black Hand with their own technology. Now, having special vehicles in Just Cause games has always just been a thing. So I'm really excited to see gameplay of this, and just knowing that you can have that stealthiness, you know, fly super, super low, pull your wings in and go through trees. I don't really know. There's just a bunch of room for activity with that. So that is gonna be absolutely insane. So diving into the other thing, so as we all know, we hear people say, do you realize Just Cause 4 is just Cause 3 with different graphics and basically a different name? Well, it's not. Now diving into the first thing is about the grappling hook. It's a very key thing in the game, and the grappling hook in this one is fully customizable, so players can add an impulse attack or alter the retractor length and distance, etc. So that's super cool. We really wanted that in Just Cause 3, but just simply didn't have it. If you were a PC player, of course a mod was available for you on that, but that just led to a whole bunch of more cool stuff. So to know that console players are still gonna have this, it's basically modding their own game. That is what I'd like to think they have done, and that's probably the best way to say what they have done to the game. So your distance, your retractor length, whatever, is entirely up to you. So the customization on that and just having the ability to do that is going to be really, really good. Now, the best thing about the game and the engine is that players can make whatever they want out of a situation. So we've seen in previous gameplays, you know, you attach a airlift to a shipping container, add some boosters on the back, and then you can pretty much ride that container across the map like a magic carpet, to say the least. And that's exactly what Screen Rant did say as well. So that's probably the best way to describe it, but you can make your own vehicle whenever you see it, basically. So your imagination is definitely the limit. Now, aim down sights have been added for the first time in Just Cause. Of course, that is going to come in super handy when it comes down to combat. And every weapon has a primary and secondary firing mechanic. And the secondary firing mechanic for that one that we've seen is actually a drone. So shooting out a drone and everything like that just blows your mind already. Now, as I said at the beginning of the video, there are 4 major regions and climates. So you've got the rainforest, grasslands, desert, and the alpine. Now, each of these come with their own unique dynamic storm patterns. So you have the windstorm, for example, tornadoes, of course, which we have seen, a sandstorm, and a blizzard. Now, all of these storms have a significant effect on a gameplay experience for everyone, and we know that Rico's car is actually completely, I guess, like indestructible to this. So he has a fully built storm chaser. We've seen that muscle car in the trailers. We haven't seen raw gameplay of it yet, but we've seen it in the trailers when he's driving straight towards the tornado. Now, it's a vehicle that is, like I said, simply immune to the wind and dangerous weather. But not all vehicles like that. You can't just like customize your vehicles and upgrade them. That is the only vehicle like that. So all of the other vehicles in the game will be affected and consumed by the storm. So if you're driving a bicycle, you are gone, more or less. If you're driving a bus, you are also gone, just like that. So that's the only vehicle in the game, so I'm gonna assume it's gonna be one of those things that you could just call in at any time, hopefully. So leading on to vehicles, you could drive whatever you see. Now that seems to be a common thing anyway in previous Just Cause games almost, but it's definitely unique in open world games nowadays. Sometimes you see a cool vehicle and you can't actually drive it, but in Just Cause 4 you can drive whatever you see, and if you see something that you could potentially make a vehicle, then you can drive that also, just like I said about the container and the boosters on the back of it. Now there are 40 individual destructible objects in the game, such as airplanes and bridges, and in Just Cause 3, just a fun fact, there were 20, so they have doubled that. I didn't even feel like there was 20, all I knew is that there are a bunch of them in Just Cause 3. So now, it more or less feels like they're going to be in every corner that you turn in Just Cause 4, which is going to be fun. Again, just leads to loads and loads of opportunities to just be creative, I guess you could say. Now, one thing everyone had a complaint about in Just Cause 3 was the loading times. Now, in Just Cause 4, it has significantly improved the loading times compared to Just Cause 3. So that's just a fun fact that I thought I would throw in there. Now, moving on to the last few things. The AI has been improved, which is great, because sometimes I felt like I was shooting enemies and they weren't really being as difficult as they looked, because you see they got all the gear on, the weapons, and you're just like, it's just super easy to take them down. So I like a challenge, especially when it comes down to combat, so know that the AI has definitely been improved, and you know, it's gonna lead to more difficult combat situations. It's something that I like to hear, because then you know, every upgrade that you do make is gonna have a gameplay impact or combat impact basically, so it just makes you wanna like earn these things that allow you to upgrade more or less. Now moving on to the last two things, everything in the game is fully physicalized, so that means every object in the game will react to you. So for example, not just that, but the dynamic weather and all other external catalysts. So there is basically everything doable in the game. Whatever you see, it will move. There's nothing going to be stiff essentially. Well, big things basically. That's probably the best way to give you guys, you know, a better image of what I'm trying to say here. So real world physics are also applied to the combat and enemies. This is not something that we did have in Just Cause 3, I think, but let's say for example, if you shoot an enemy in the chest, you'll actually see a bullet hole on that part of his or her body. So the same thing also applies to Rika. If you're gonna get shot in the head, you're gonna see a bullet on your head. I feel like that was in Just Cause 3, but maybe like scarring and all that stuff is gonna have a bigger impact. If the same real world physics, like if you just come out of like a full on gun, I don't know, blast out, right? And you've got like blood everywhere, scars, like hopefully that does just stay on your character for a while and then eventually fade up, or maybe you just have to like get health for you to get rid of that. I don't really know, but I feel like that would be something really, really cool to have. So those are the main key things. Now the downside of course is we know single player focus, there's no multiplayer, and it does utilize a brand new Apex engine, which is 15 years in the making and makes all the destruction possible. So a whole lot more power in this game. Hopefully we're not going to get a low frame rate like we did in Just Cause 3 when it did come down to like going to the city and causing explosions there. The frame rate was really, really bad. So with a powerful engine can of course mean you could do more powerful stuff at a smoother experience. So those are all the new details we have, and that hopefully gives you a better indication that this game is not exactly the same as Just Cause 3, okay? They have given us every single tool that we have requested, obviously apart from multiplayer, but as far as every other tool we now have. So those are the new details. If there's anything you feel I missed or something you want to still see in the game, then let me know in the comment section below and I may just make another video discussing that. But that's going to wrap up this one here. Subscribe for more awesome content if you haven't already. If you also missed a previous Just Cause video, the link is in the description below, and of course there is a playlist. But I will see you in the next one. Until then, have a great day and adios amigos.